Hello, this is Tanya Hakla, and this is my presentation on conflict resolution for Project Management 800, Leading Teams. My talk is going to be split into three parts. I'm going to talk about the nature of conflict, then I'll talk about responding to conflict and different communications strategies, and then I'll talk about managing conflict and grievances. So, the nature of conflict. What is conflict? The Oxford English Dictionary defines conflict as a serious disagreement or argument, typically a protracted one. Condliff says, conflict is a form of relating or interacting where we find ourselves, either as individuals or groups, under some sort of perceived threat to our personal or collective goals. These goals are usually to do with our interpersonal wants. These perceived threats may either be real or imagined. So, that doesn't sound very pleasant, but conflict can be good as well. It can lead to increased creativity, it forces people to clarify their views, it can produce constructive social change, and gives people the opportunity to test their capacities. This can lead to the development of group and organization bonding and solidarity. The other side of the coin, if conflict isn't dealt with constructively, is it could lead to the breakdown of relationships and collaborations, polarization of views into static positions, the destruction of communication, where no one is listening to each other anymore, and groupthink. Now, how can conflict lead to groupthink? As conflict escalates, there begins to be strong pressure to conform to a certain way of thinking, which leads to the breakdown of critical thinking. The danger being that eventually conflict will cease because everyone is conforming to the dominant voice. Which leads to responding to conflict. How a team leader or project manager responds to conflict can influence not only how the conflict is managed now, but what the team does when it comes to conflict in the future. Jerry King says, conflict is not negative, but how it is handled can be. So, conflict handling styles. There's avoiding, which is ignoring conflicts and hoping they'll go away. It should only be used for trivial conflicts or for short time to allow a cool down or see if the situation will resolve itself. Misuse can lead to issues like the groupthink example. Compromise, best to use when those who are in conflict are equal in power and have mutually exclusive goals, or when a solution needs to be arrived at quickly. Compromise too much and nobody wins. It's the lose-lose scenario. Competition should only be used when a quick, decisive action is very important or the issue is one that is vital to the company's welfare. This is the win-lose scenario. The danger is it leads to power plays and possible creations of hierarchy within the team. Accommodation. Useful when the issue is more important to the other party, or creating harmony and stability is more important at that point in time. It can also be used to let team members learn from their mistakes. Overuse can lead to people thinking you are a pushover, and if they fight long enough, you'll give in. Collaboration, a longer process, but a good problem solving and learning opportunity. The team can begin to see problems and conflicts as challenges to work together and overcome to a win-win solution. So, it comes down to depending on the problem, that should influence which style a team leader uses. This requires the project manager to overcome the natural inclination to use a style that they're good at all times, and to learn to read the situation at hand. Which brings us to managing conflict. How do you deal with interpersonal conflicts? You can model the attitudes and behaviors you want your team to emulate. Identify any sources of conflict as early as possible. Keep aware that petty conflicts may be masking larger issues. And focus on tasks, not personalities. Create a blame-free culture. Address the conflicts in a timely way. Learn from conflict to help improve handling of future situations. So, how about intergroup conflicts? You need to build trust, clearly define the participants' roles and authorities, establish ground rules, maintain participant continuity. Stay cognizant of resources and time constraints. Address the cultural differences and power imbalances. And as always, maintain good listening skills and use the conflict as a learning opportunity to improve future situations. So, what are the take-home points for any conflict? Stay calm, practice good listening skills, don't assume that people are being difficult intentionally, and maintain or enhance self-esteem of all of those who are involved. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the talk and you got something useful out of it.